For this lesson, you need to open the sample file World Sales 1 from your Sample Files folder. I'm now going to move the chart embedded in this worksheet to a different position on the screen. To do that, I'll click just inside the border of the chart to activate it. And notice that when it's activated, a border appears around the chart, three little icons appear on the top right corner, and the Chart Tools group appears on the ribbon. I'm now going to hover the mouse cursor just inside the border of the chart, and notice that I see the four-headed arrow cursor shape. Be very careful not to hover the mouse over one of the sizing handles on the corner or center of one of the sides when you'll see the two-headed arrow cursor shape. When you're sure you're seeing the four-headed arrow cursor shape, click and drag, and you can freely move the chart anywhere you want to on the screen. Now let's look at resizing the chart using one of those sizing handles. The sizing handles are on the corners of the chart and also midway along each side of the chart. I'm going to hover the mouse cursor over the bottom right corner sizing handle of the chart, and then when I click and drag, I can freely size the chart to any size that I want. Notice that I've now distorted the perspective of the chart. By that I mean that I can make the chart very wide and short and have short stumpy bars, or I can make it very tall and thin and have long thin vertical bars. But most of the time you'll want to retain the original perspective. Here's how you can resize without distorting the perspective. First I'll put things back the way they were by clicking the Undo button on the Quick Access toolbar several times. Now that the chart's back to its original size, I'm going to hold down the Shift key on the keyboard and then hover over that bottom right corner sizing handle. And now when I click and drag, you can see that it's impossible to distort the perspective of the chart. So I can resize and maintain the original perspective. Now I'm going to duplicate the chart using copy and paste. To do that, I'll click just inside the border of the chart to activate it, and then right-click and select copy from the shortcut menu. Now I'll right-click in any other blank cell and select paste from the shortcut menu. And you can see that I've made a duplicate of the chart. Note that even though the new chart's a duplicate, it's not linked to the original chart in any way. You can freely change any part of either chart and it will never affect the other. Let's demonstrate that now. I'll click just inside the border of the copied chart to activate it, and then on the ribbon I'll select Chart Tools and Design. Now you'll remember from lesson 5.1 that charts can have styles. Styles include things such as the background colour and the fonts used in a chart. You'll notice that on the Design tab, there's a Chart Styles gallery, and I'll open this gallery now to see many different predefined chart styles. And because it's a gallery, I can hover over any of the predefined chart styles and see a preview of the effect this has on my chart on the worksheet. Well, I think I'll choose the chart style with the black background, so I'll click on this style and the styles applied to the chart on the worksheet. But you can see that the original chart hasn't changed in any way. When you have multiple charts embedded in a worksheet, it's useful to give them meaningful names. If I click just inside the border of the duplicated chart to activate it, you can see by looking in the name box that this chart currently has the default name of Chart 3. Well, that's not a very meaningful name, so I'll click inside the name box and I'll name this chart Black Chart. And it's very important that you press the Enter key at this point, otherwise you won't save the name. Now I'll click on the original chart just inside the border to activate it, and I'll name this chart White Chart. And once again, I won't forget to press the Enter key. If I click on each chart in turn now, you can see that they've been named appropriately. When charts have meaningful names, it makes them easier to find in the Selection and Visibility task pane. Let's now bring up the Selection and Visibility task pane and see this working. So I'll click inside the border of either of the charts to activate it, and on the ribbon I'll click the Chart Tools Format tab. And notice there's an Arrange group, and one of the icons in the Arrange group is Selection Pane. So I'll click Selection Pane, and the Selection and Visibility task pane appears. And you can see my two charts, the black chart and the white chart. I can click on either of these charts in the Selection and Visibility task pane, and the chart's activated. You can see the black chart is activated now, and now the white chart is activated. Now you might wonder why this is useful. Well, with just two charts embedded on the worksheet, it's not really very useful. You can easily simply click on either chart to activate it. But imagine a case where you had 100 charts embedded on a worksheet. It would be very difficult to find one of the charts, and the Selection and Visibility task pane makes this very easy. There's also another feature on the Selection and Visibility task pane that enables you to hide a chart. Notice there's a little eyeball icon to the right of each chart. I'm going to click on that icon now for the white chart, and notice that it's now hidden. The chart's still there, but you can't see it. I'll now click in the same place again, and the white chart returns. And let's do the same with the black chart. Hide and show. I'll now close the Selection and Visibility task pane by clicking the cross in the top right-hand corner. Now I'm going to delete the duplicated chart. I'll click just inside the border to activate it and press the delete key on the keyboard. And the chart's gone. Now let's talk about chart worksheets. A chart worksheet is a special worksheet without any cells that can only contain a single chart. And sometimes it's better to keep charts and data separate by placing a chart in its own chart worksheet. Let's do that now. So I'll right-click just inside the corner of the chart to both activate it and bring up the shortcut menu. And then I'll select Move Chart from the shortcut menu. And instead of being an object in Sheet 1, I'll move the chart to its own chart sheet. Excel has given this the default name of Chart 1, but I'll give it a more meaningful name, and I'll call it Sales Summary Chart. When I click the OK button, the chart is moved from the Sheet 1 worksheet onto its own chart worksheet called Sales Summary Chart. Now, my students often ask me whether it's better to keep charts on their own chart worksheets or to embed charts on a regular worksheet. Well, there's three advantages to keeping your charts on chart sheets. The first is that they're easier to find because you can give each chart sheet a meaningful name. Secondly, they're easier to view because the chart normally takes up the entire screen. You can resize a chart on a chart sheet, but this isn't often done. And finally, they're easier to print because you can simply click on the Chart Sheet tab and print. You could also print an embedded chart in isolation, but to do so, you'd have to first find and activate the chart. But there's one big advantage of embedding a chart within a worksheet, and that is that you're able to print the chart and the associated worksheet data on the same page. But if you've got no need to print worksheet data alongside your chart, it's usually better to place your charts on separate chart sheets. But let's imagine that in this case I do want to print both the data and chart, so I need to move this chart back so that it's embedded in Sheet 1. To do that, I'll right-click just inside the border of the chart and then select Move Chart from the shortcut menu. And instead of appearing on its own Sales Summary Chart sheet, I'll click Object in Sheet 1. And when I click OK, the chart's moved back to its original location. All that remains for this lesson is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name, World Sales 2, and as usual, I'll save in the folder above, my sample files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed Lesson 5.3, Move, Resize, Copy, and Delete a Chart.